हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ मिसेस प्रतिभा सोनोने, फैकल्टी फ्रॉम श्री जैन विद्या प्रसारक मंडल्स, रसिकलाल एम धारीवल कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मसी, चिंचोड, पुणे. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कैटेगरी लैक्सेटिव्स, विच इज वन ऑफ द कैटेगरी फ्रॉम फार्माकोलॉजिकल ग्रुपिंग ऑफ नेचुरल ड्रग्स चैप्टर फ्रॉम फार्माकोग्नोसी सब्जेक्ट फॉर फर्स्ट ईयर डी फार्मसी स्टूडेंट्स. This is the part 1 of this video. Learning outcomes. After watching this video, you will be able to define laxatives, classification of the laxatives, and the study of aloe and isabgol, two drugs. Let us start with the definition and classification of the laxatives. Laxatives, it is a English word derived from old French word laxative, which came from the Latin word laxatus. Laxatus, it is again made up of the two Latin words known as laxare and laxus. Laxare means to loosen, while the Latin word laxus means to loose. A laxative or purgative is a food compound or medication which, when consumed, either induces bowel movements or loosens the stool. So these are the drugs which loose the bowels or intestines, or the drugs producing increasing and hastening intestinal evacuation, or the drugs which promote defecation. Defecation means push out the excreta from the body through the anus. Laxatives have milder action than the purgatives. Laxatives expel soft form stools, while the purgatives results in more fluid evacuation of the bowels. Depending upon the intensities of the drug effects, the laxatives are categorized into four categories. First category is laxatives. These drugs suggest the elimination of soft form stools. It is also called as mild purgatives. For example, carboxymethyl cellulose, senna, liquid paraffin. Second class is purgatives. Purgatives suggest more fluid evacuation. For example, castor oil, aloe, rhubarb, etc. Third category is drastics. Drastics act intentionally by irritating the mucous membrane of the intestine. For example, jalap, colocynth, and podophyllum. And fourth class is hydrogogus. Hydrogogus produces fluid motions such as croton oil and colocynth. The mechanism of action of the laxatives may be either bulk forming, irritating, or emollient, depending upon the chemical nature of the active constituent. Laxatives are indicated in constipation and evacuation of the bowel prior to the diagnostic procedures or the surgeries. Let us see which drugs comes under this category. First drug is aloe. Synonym of aloe is aloe only. Biological source: it is a dried juice of the leaves of Aloe barbadensis miller, which is also called as Curacea aloes. Second variety is Aloe peribaker. It is also called as Socotrine aloes. And third variety is hybrids of Aloe ferox miller and Aloe africans miller or Aloe spicata baker, which is called as a Cape aloes. So three varieties are available in the market: Aloe barbadensis, Aloe peribaker, and hybrids of Aloe ferox miller and Aloe africans and Aloe spicata. This drug belongs to the family Liliaceae. Organoleptic characteristic: color depends on the variety from which it is obtained. It is dark brown, brownish black, or black in color. Its odor is characteristic. Taste is intensely bitter and nauseating. Size found in the form of masses of various sizes. Let us see the different varieties of this alum. There are three varieties of the alum. While preparation or the various methods are used to prepare the alloys commercially. Most common method of preparation is that the fleshy and sessile leaves of aloe are cut near the bases and are arranged in the wooden trough or kerosene tin or vessels of the goat skin as to form the V-shaped cavity by placing the cut end downwards. The leaves are allowed to drain fully. The juice is then taken to evaporating pans and concentrated. Methods of its concentration and cooling results in physical variations in alloys. So, vigorous concentration followed by quick cooling results in transparent and brittle product known as vitreous or lucid alloys, whereas slow concentration with gradual cooling produces hepatic or livery alloys. Let us see three varieties of this alloy. First is Cape alloy, second is Gorakia alloy, and third is Socotrin alloy. Cape alloys, it is dark brown or greenish brown or glossy masses. Masses are transparent when mounted in glycerin and the crystal particles are observed. The fracture of this type of alloy is glossy in nature. Second variety is Gorakia alloys. Its color is dark chocolate brown. It is usually opaque in nature and fracture is waxy in nature. Third variety is Socotrin alloy. It is reddish black to brownish black color. It is opaque in nature and smooth conchoidal. Let us discuss the chemical constituents. All varieties of alloys contains a yellow colored crystalline substance known as barbaloin, which is a C glycoside. It also contains resin, alloimodine, and the isobarbaloin is present in Gorakia and Cape alloy, characterized by the presence of an amorphous compound, beta barbaloin, alunosides A and B, and caprylazotanol with p-coumaric acids. The resins of Gorakia variety contains barbalo-resinotanol with the cinnamic acid. So this alloy contains 30% of alloin, which is a mixture of three isomers such as barbaloin, beta barbaloin, and isobarbaloin. It also contains alloimodine, alunosides A and B, caprylazotanol with p-coumaric acid, barbalo-resinotanol with cinnamic acid, and tetrabromalin. Let us discuss different identification test. Before going for the test, we have to prepare a solution. Prepare 1% solution of alloy by boiling with water. Add 0.5% of Kieselguhr to it. Then filter it. And this filtrate used for the next test. First test is Schottentein test or Schottentein's reaction. Take 5 ml of filtrate, to that add 0.2 gram of borax and heat this solution. Add this solution to a test tube containing water. After addition, a green fluorescence is produced due to the presence of alloimodine in the alloys. Second test, take 2 ml of test solution or the filtrate, to that add 2 ml of freshly prepared bromine water solution. Yellow, pale yellow precipitate is produced. This precipitate is due to the precipitation of tetrabromalin in the alloy. Third test, 5 ml of test solution plus 2 ml of nitric acid. In this test, we will get different coloration with the different varieties, such as Cape aloe gives yellowish brown to green color, Curacao aloe gives reddish orange color, Socotrine aloe gives pale brownish yellow color, Zanzibar aloe gives yellowish brown color. So these tests can be used for the differentiation of the different varieties of the aloes. Fourth test is Glung's test. 2 ml aqueous solution plus a drop of saturated copper sulfate solution is taken, followed by 0.5 gram of sodium chloride and 2 ml of 90% alcohol is added. Here also we will get different coloration with different varieties. Curacao aloes, it gives wine red color. Cape aloe, a faint coloration is developed. Zanzibar and Socotrine aloes, they do not respond to this taste. So we can identify the varieties from this taste also, except Zanzibar and Socotrine aloes. Fifth test, it is a very important test, modified Brown Tiger test, which is mostly used for the identification of the glycosides present in the drug. In this test, first take 0.1 gram of drug. To that, add 2 ml of 5% ferric chloride solution plus 2 ml dilute hydrochloric solution. This solution is heated on boiling water bath for 5 minutes. Let it cool and shake with the benzene, which is used as an organic solvent. Separate the benzene layer. Add equal volume of dilute ammonia solution to this benzene layer. A pinkish red color is produced with all varieties of the aloes, which shows the presence of the glycosides. Let us discuss uses of aloe. Aloe, it is used as an irritant purgative. It acts on colon to counteract the effects. The gripping action of aloe, it is given with the carminatives. Third use is, it is used in the cosmetics as a protective and clear skin blemishes and grows new and healthy tissues on the skin. It stimulates the growth of hairs. It is also applied for the painful inflammations of the joints. Second drug is Isabgula. Synonym is Isabgol, Isabgol and Xylem. Biological source, it consists of dried ripe seeds of Plantago ovata and Plantago indica, belonging to family Plantaginaceae. The origin of this word Isabgol lies in the Persian word Isab, which means the horse, and gol means the ear. The literal meaning of word Isabgol is the ear of the horse. The seeds as well as the husk of the seeds are used in the medicine since 18th century. About 10 species of the drugs are available in India. Seeds are very small in size. 1,000 seeds weigh about only 1.5 gram. Isabgol has high export potential value. Isabgol consists of dried seeds of plant known as Plantago ovata, belonging to family Plantaginaceae. In the pharmaceutical fields, seeds as well as the dried seed coats known as Isabgol husk are used. Organoleptic characteristics of this drug. Color is pinkish gray to brown. Odor is none. Taste is mucilaginous and shape is, seeds are oval with a spot in the center of the convex dorsal surface. Concave surface contains the hilum covered with thin membrane having two perforations. Let us discuss different identification tests for this isabgol. Dry seeds of isabgol plus add 1 drop of test solution of the Chinese ink. Mucilage shows transparent, spherically dilated fragments on black background. Second, test solution plus ruthenium red, it gives pink color. Third test, dry the seeds and add drop of thionine test solution. Wait for 10 minutes. Then wash this with the alcohol. Mucilage will turn violet red. Chemical constituents of this drug. The seeds contains mucilage with which on hydrolysis gives L-arabinose, L-rhamnose, D-galactose, D-galacturonic acids. Seeds also contain fixed oils and proteins. Swelling factor is supposed to be criteria of the purity of the drug. Swelling factor of this drug is a quantitative swelling due to the mucilage present in the drug. It is determined by putting 1 gram of the drug in the measuring cylinder of 25 ml capacity in 20 ml water with occasional shaking. The volume occupied by the seeds after 24 hours of swelling is measured. The swelling factor for the seeds is 10 to 14. This test is also used for the identification of the seeds. It is called as a swelling factor test. Uses of the drug. Seeds and husk used as laxative, demulcent and emollient. It is used in case of chronic constipation, used in treatment of microbial dysentery. Also, the mucilage of isabgol is used in preparation of the tablets. It is also used as a stabilizer in ice cream industries due to the mucilage present in it. It is the pollutase of crushed seeds used to relieve the pains of the joints. Adulterants and substitutes for the isabgol. Adulterants, Plantago lanceolata and Plantago asiata. And substitute is Plantago xylem, which is also called as a xylem seeds or flea seeds. I hope all of you have understood what is the meaning of laxative, its classification, its mode of action, and the two drugs, aloe and the isabgol. In next video, we will discuss another drug which comes under this category. Thank you.